Anurag Batra, Chairman, Business World. My friend, Mr. Naren Nath, who is there in the NSCS, and everyone who is present here. Good afternoon, rather good evening to all of you. Sorry, I was somewhere else, and so I couldn't join in the morning, and somehow I squeezed in and made, actually, thanks to nice of him, Mr. Batra has come back all the way from home to join this session. And the previous session was also very interesting to listen to all the speakers who participated in the discussion, particularly the most important topic, the cyber security. Coming to the defense and aerospace, the scenario in the last, let's say, about 2 decades, it has been changing, and the technological growth has been steady. And then in the last about 5 to 6 years, the growth has been exponential. Whether in the technologies development, systems development, systems induction, or the industry, the way it has been participating and industry, the way it has taken up, is tremendous in the country. Look at in the aerospace sector, if you look at it, the LCA, which has had IOC initial operational clearance, then has gone through final operational clearance, and then looking at the systems which are coming out, the Air Force has gone out with 83 numbers of LCA order on HAL, which is the single largest ever at a single order number. And HAL is moving ahead, promising that we'll be able to do per year 18 numbers and 24 numbers, whatever it is, they're working on that and trying to go ahead. Similarly, look at the helicopters. HAL has developed multiple helicopters, ALH, LUH, NUH, many things, which actually the armed forces are again ordering and getting into armed forces in a big way. And then moving on in that same direction, today AMCA, Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft, the 50th generation aircraft, which the design phase is going on seriously, is makes the country in a couple of years the capability to have a 50th generation fighter aircraft in, that, in the country. Similarly, the Navy is also looking for, having got the naval aircraft landing on Vikramaditya, taking off multiple trials and everything, given the complete confidence for the Navy to look for a 10-engine deck-based fighter aircraft, is one thing in the aerospace aviation sector, the way the country has progressed. Today, a number of industries have come who are able to take on. And today, we are able to commit to the nation very aggressive schedules for development of these systems, is because the industries, the way they have come up, and they are able to develop, and they are able to promise that the systems will be able to come out very fast. Meaning, if you look at about 10 years back, most of the industries in the country were built to print. Now today they all migrated to build to specifications. Majority of the avionics today comes from the industry. Majority of other actuation systems and related systems come from industry in a build to specification manner. In fact, today the Indian industry is supplying to various major aircraft manufacturers in the world, various systems from here, whether it is cable loom or actuation systems and whatnot. Many things are going from multiple industries today, or some of them are getting it manufactured here as JV or whatever, the way Tatas are doing for the helicopters and all that. So there are many industries who are getting supplies from India through our industries today, which are manufacturing. The aerospace manufacturing sector has come up in a big way. Similarly, you look at the other side. Today, we could develop in this country the world's longest range artillery gun, 155mm class, which is undergoing the final phase of the trials today. World's longest range 155mm artillery gun. You see, earlier we couldn't develop a gun in the country, and now whereas a complete indigenous gun, everything right from forging barrels and whatnot, ammunitions, everything have been developed in the country. So you, this is a path has been laid for producing any type of a gun in the country today. Once you develop, actually this country can take on actually. That is the first one is the bottleneck. After that, we are too good to expand in a multiple ways also. Similarly, today radars, you talk about, I can very confidently say that today we are completely self-reliant and self-sufficient in the radars technology, including the basic core things, like TR modules, gallium arsenide-based, gallium nitride-based TR modules of various powers we are able to develop, the phased array radars, whatever are required, and varieties of radars. Today, whether the number of radars inducted in the armed forces, which are more than about 1,800 radars, or the various radars which are under induction, under development, and you look at it, we don't have to look outside at all. Even very long-range radars are also, we are able to develop in the country. We can develop in that. Similarly, missiles is one more area where we are very strong. We can develop today surface-to-surface missiles or surface-to-air missiles or anti-tank missiles, air-to-ground missiles. You talk about more air-to-air missiles, talking about Astra or various other missiles, we are able to develop. And I can say that more than 90% is indigenous in all these things. The indigenous content is more than that. It's actually the semiconductor which is not there in the foundry, is not there in the country. That is what you need to get it. Otherwise, almost all are there. The participation of industry in this is tremendous. One example I'll give you. The Akash missile, which is actually had large orders, more than about 30,000 crores worth of orders. And the BDL is the prime agency for producing the missiles. And when BDL is producing the missiles, it is 85% by value are coming from the private industry. That's how BDL could promise or could do and promise that I will be able to double the production also per month, because the supply chain is so much and coming from the industries, and each part, at least there are 2-3 suppliers and was able to develop. This is how the system has evolved. So today I can say that we are very strong in the missiles, radars, sonars, torpedoes, electronic warfare systems. We are able to build AEW systems, AWC, the Embraer bears, the AWC has been already successfully delivered to the Indian Air Force. And then we are making guns now. We are making the aircrafts now today. We are making communication systems. So we are able to develop most of the systems today in the country. And now it is the phase now where we have to go for most advanced technologies, making the industry develop the current technologies based systems and then move ahead for research in the advanced technologies. So today we need to make the industry come up with a lot of D&D capability. Developing many technological based systems is one of the most important things. That's how DRDO, which actually about 5 years back, 10 years back, normally the process was that DRDO takes a project, you do the design, you do the development, then you do your own trials, and then you go to the armed forces, then you do the user trials with the armed forces, then identify a production agency, you give it to him, and then he produces it and do again one more trial, which is called FOPM trial and all. Now this has changed. Firstly, we have identified a mechanism called DCPP, development come production partner. The day you take the project, the industry is identified, he joins with you, he is there part of you, and you place the developmental order on him. The first 10 numbers, 20 numbers, whatever are required, you are placing order day one. He is there with you, he is learning with you, and the first prototype, what is coming out, is not from DRDO, it is coming from the industry. DRDO is helping the industry to make the system and come out. And so the first system which is going for the trials is directly from the industry. This is number one. So all this number of trials have been shortcut. The new defense acquisition procedure has brought in the concept of JPMTs, wherein the DRDO, industry, armed forces, quality assurance agencies, all together put as one joint team, JPMT. They are the people who decide each and every aspect. They monitor, they participate, they go ahead, they take the decisions, everything. And so all has been integrated. Now there is one integrated trial. What has been earlier, almost about 4 sets of trials have been brought into one single set of trial, and all are together. And the industry is geared up with the right from the first prototype model. And this is how the system to promote the industry and making them come up. And I want to tell you here, today, you talk about missiles or bombs, which were not for the private industry earlier. It was only for the public sector DPSUs, have been opened up. There are at least about 6 or 7 missiles and bombs tenders which have come out where private industries have participated and private industries have backed the DCPP contract and participating and trying to make today missiles and bombs by the private sector. This is a major change in the last 1 year or 1.5 years. And now a lot more are going to be tendered, and all the missiles and the bombs which are going to come out will be private sector also will be involved, and mostly they will also be, most of them will be getting the orders. This is one more major change, the critical strategy, which are critical systems which have been very confidential today, have been opened up to the private sector. They're coming up in a big way. Second, private sector, when they make, the test facilities have been an issue. Test facilities have been opened up. Private sector can access, the mechanisms have been worked, how do they pay and all. This is one more thing. The patents have been opened up. DRDO, whatever the patents have been made, they have been put it in the website, and then people can access it, and they started accessing it. Already about 25 people have taken up, and they're trying to work on these problems, and all that is one more important thing what has been given. Second, industry is trying to develop on its own something, and they need a help from DRDO. There's a mechanism work where DRDO will help the industry, or scientists will go and sit in the industry, help them and all that, and mechanism has been worked out where industry comes out with a problem, you are finding a solution to them, and that mechanism has been worked out. This is another very important. Then, to see that industry comes out with lots of development of various, call it as technology-based systems or systems or subsystems or parts, are most of the things what we are importing today for most of the foreign aircrafts or submarines or helicopters or many other systems. All these, either to indigenize them or the new systems, new technologies to develop, a scheme has been promulgated, which is technology development funding, wherein either we defend the problem or we defend the spare part or subsystem which we are importing or a system we define. Or the industry, Suomoto, can come out with a proposal wherein to develop the system, to come out with this technology, 10 crore rupees funding is done by the, there are already about 42 such cases have been awarded to the industry today. There are 42 cases. And there are another about 40 to 50 are in the pipeline which are being done. Even the youngsters who are just passed out of the college, if they are part of an incubator in that institute or university, through that incubation center for the youngster, anything up to 1 crore or beyond that also can be funded. This is another scheme which has been promulgated very recently, and all the incubation centers in the country, including IITs, have been informed about it, and trying to attract a lot of youngsters to get into this scheme is another important mechanism what has been brought to support the design and development activity in the industry in a big way. And seeing all these things, you must have seen that the Israel IMOD has come forward saying that let us jointly fund both in India and also in Israel, and we'll work together. We will also fund, you also fund, and make these two people work together and come out. Of course, it is start as dualist technologies, whether artificial intelligence or robotics or drones and this sort of a things. We'll be working together. You must have seen just about 2 days back, we have signed this agreement, and Israel IMOD, the R&D, DDR&D chief was here, and me and he both signed that. And we are going to support the Indian industry. Of course, same way in the Israeli side also, whoever comes forward, we'll be supporting them and funding them and come out with that. So there are lots of mechanisms are coming, come out, and there are a lot more going to come out. A lot more also, continuously things are being worked out. Similarly, there are a lot of schemes which have been brought out to support the export from the industries. This is another important thing. A lot of things have been simplified. And we also have made a compendium of total products which can be exported. Of course, all the things are done by industry only. See, DRDO is not producing, DRDO is not exporting, DRDO doesn't do any of these things. DRDO just does the R&D and makes the prototype, earlier prototype DRDO was making, now that also industry is making. So support the industry to come out. And so this compendium has been circulated all in across all the embassies in the world, where our Indian defense attaches are there, given them and see that what are the market and all. So there are lots of inquiries are also coming. A lot of change. A lot of countries are asking for lots of products today. And I'm sure that in the coming couple of years, there will be a lot of jump in the export from Indian side where for the various products, industries also. In fact, what I want to say is earlier, we were not thinking of so. We were not marketing, actually. We were not telling these are the products available. Now we are feeling the necessity that yes, suppose BDL has produced Akash missiles, let's say whatever it is, 1500, 2000 missiles, whatever they have produced. Now what to do next? You have to do next means you have to export. So you have to see that you are telling that there is a product, this is the cost of the product, and it is available much cheaper than any other country. These things have to be done. And so people started doing it. And so a lot of things will be coming up with this change in the attitude, perception of our industries also. See, one thing is very clear. Any industry here just cannot survive with our own armed forces order. Yes, that can be a beginning. But then you have to continue and you have to earn a lot of business and you have to sustain with this product at least for about 10 years. You need to get the business from outside. So that is one thing what we need to work on. And for that, the technologies which are needed today, they have to be advanced. We should not be lagging. One thing is very clear. I always, every time, whenever I talk anywhere, I keep saying that we have been technology followers. Somebody develops, we also develop it after 4 years, 5 years, or 6 years, whatever it is. Now the scenario is completely different. See, when our Honorable Prime Minister has given the call for saying that self-reliant in India, Atmanirbhar, means he is not saying that you just get produced in the country here. You produce the most advanced technology here, first of its kind product here. You should have the design, development, and production capability in this country. How advanced? Like the drone system, anti-drone system, we have come out here in this country. We are not lagging with anybody. The day if there was a system outside available in Europe, the same system was available in India parallelly here. Whether it is soft kill or detection mechanisms, various detection mechanisms or hard kill, everything was available here. So like that, we should not be lagging or we should be leading. We should be doing the first of its kind system. That technologies we should be concentrating, we should be doing, and make the industries come out, produce these technologies in a fast mechanism. The mechanisms also have to be faster. See, all said and done, there have been, the processes have been very slow in this, and they need to be hastened, they need to be simplified. Started simplifying a lot, like I said, in the export policy and all that. Many other things also. Let's say in DRDO, if TDF we were taking earlier to fund the industry 1 year, now we have brought it down to 4 months. And we are trying to work, still can we reduce this period. And any contract you have to pay, it used to take 8 months, 9 months, 1 year. Now we are trying to say that we should do it in 3 months. So this sort of a thing, quickly, how can you do that and quickly make the industry come and you work with the industry and the industry absorbs it and makes it faster. That is what it is. See, today, one is technology, advanced technology. Second most important thing, essence of the time. When the product is coming. See, you may make a product after 2 years coming out, the product coming out, there's no meaning in coming out. Today, at the right time, when the world is looking for and the world should get a surprise from this development. That is what is required and we need to work on that. I'm sure that the way we are working with various academic institutes in the country, like we can see here in Delhi, IIT, the type of developments what are happening, we should be able to do. And the way industry is integrating, the way industry is showing, and the way the startups are coming up, this is one of the most important things what we have to see. Even about till 4 years back, firstly, there were very few startups in the country. Now today, you must be seeing that in DPIIT, the number of startups which are registered are more than 50,000. Second, earlier, any youngster means whichever faculty has come from, he used to be working only on information technology or information communication technology, ICT. But today's scenario is different. Today, I can tell you the people who are coming to us, working with us, are they're working on materials technologies. Composites, they're working. They're working on propulsion technologies. They're working on engine technologies. See, the core technologies, subjects, where is the information technology? And today, people are talking about these subjects. And youngsters are working on all these things. That is one of the important change major change in the country, what is happening is this, where our youngsters are looking for these core technologies coming out. And if we are able to promote them, the schemes what we have brought out and many schemes which are coming out, we are sure that we'll be able to lead the world in all these things. Next 5 years are the most crucial. How we are able to promote all these things, how we are able to work together. I think the last question you were asking in the previous session also, how all these people can work together. And that is the most important things. Whether academia coming out with the core technologies, R&D organization taking from there to a translational research, industry picking up, producing them, and coming out with innovations. This is the way, if we are able to work together, the country will lead and we'll make the country lead the world, and the country will become prosperous, and we will be a major, major defense hub. And what Honorable Prime Minister said, that change from a leading importer to a leading exporter. This is what our motto. I'm sure that we'll be able to fulfill it. Thank you very much for organizing such a major thing and a good subject. And I congratulate you and your team for doing such thing. And thank you very much for inviting me also. Thank you.